Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Andrew here with Friffy Films coming at you with another quick tip. I've been messing a lot with audio and Adobe Audition the past couple weeks, so I figured it was a good time to show you guys about the Spot Heal Brush and the Noise Reduction Tool. Let's check it out.
Quick tips, quick tips, quick tips, quick tips.
Oh, hey, Andrew here with Friffy Films. Welcome to Quick Tips, the show where we quickly go over tips. Still kind of working on that slogan. Today we're using Adobe Audition to go over our top three tips for fixing bad audio. Assuming you do not have the luxury to re-record your material, our first tip would be the noise removal technique. We're gonna launch Audition. We're gonna drag in our audio. Gonna double click on this guy. And here we have some audio. Right?
Hey, microphone check 1, 2. 1, 2, there's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this.
So this one has a little bit of a fan noise underneath. You can hear here. Right. Basically, we're going to isolate that and tell Adobe Audition to take those frequencies only out of there. So let's check it out here. I'm going to zoom into the timeline. I'm just pinching and zooming on my trackpad here. But basically, you want to select the section that is just the fan noise that you want to remove. That is actually, that's pretty good. The first step you want to do for the noise removal technique is you're going to go up to Effects, Noise Reduction / Restoration, and you're going to capture the noise print. Now, you want to remember, only do this once you've highlighted a specific area, or it's going to capture the noise print of the entire file here. So anyway, you go into Noise Reduction and Restoration, and you're going to capture the noise print of that specific section. Little box pops up, just click OK there. Boom, so now we captured just the fan noise of that selection. Now if we do Command A, we can select the entire track, and then we go back into Effects, Noise Reduction / Restoration, and this time we're going to hit Noise Reduction Process. And what this is basically done is it is gonna remove just the fan noise now, so check it out. Let's see what we got so far.
Hey, microphone check 1, 2. 1, 2, there's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this little...
So you see there's these frequencies here in the green when they're going up and down. That's basically all that... The frequencies
fan
of the
near
fan.
Me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise?
Bring it up and sort of hide it up here. It's pretty...
Quite possibly take out the fan noise underneath when I'm talking?
There's a clear difference there. So far, it's going pretty well, and it's isolating
I'm talking.
It, right? Once you do this effect, it sort of starts to sound a little bit, like, digitally, and it has, like, this weird, like... Like it sounds like it's on the internet or something like that. I think a good setting for this is usually 0, smoothing for 1, precision factor 7, but as usual, I just kind of mess around with these settings until I find something that works for what I'm using. In general, this probably works pretty well.
Fan near me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise underneath when I'm talking?
Let's just go ahead and apply that, right? And you saw that it kind of, from there to there, let me just undo that. You see how big and wide the waves are, and then when you kind of redo that, you see how it kind of crushes everything, and it's doing its best to take out just the frequency of the fan there.
1, 2, there's a fan near me.
So that's tip number 1, is the noise removal technique. You just want to remember to highlight the specific frequency. You capture the noise print in noise reduction / restoration first. Then you select the entire track, and then the noise reduction process. All right, and tip number 2, once I get the noise reduction tool going, I also like to give it a little bit of a noise gate. You can go down to the effects rack here, amplitude and compression, and then go to dynamics. And then we're gonna put a little gate on it. And basically what that does, it's gonna tell the microphone to not even open up and, you know, let a signal pass through until it reaches a certain decibel. You can really kind of preemptively cut out a lot of that noise by not letting the microphone open up until it reaches a certain point, like when somebody's directly speaking into it. So I actually find that the auto setting in here works pretty well with the gate here. So
hey, microphone check 1, 2.
So let's just click auto gate.
check 1 2. Hey, microphone check 1 2. 1 2, there's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this little fan near me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise?
So you see how it kind of, when there's not a lot of sound kind of coming in, it sort of cuts off at a certain frequency, and it just sort of deadens the rest of that room tone, and you just get that clear, crisp audio that you're trying to achieve.
Underneath, when I'm talking, right next to the fan, is it possible to take out that buzz?
So that's awesome. That's sounding pretty good so far. And again, you can always go in and adjust the decibel seconds, the attack, the release, hold, and all of this until you find something that sounds good with what you're working with. So again, tip number 2 is adding a gate after you have already done your noise removal tool. You just go into your effects rack, amplitude and compression, dynamics, and you have your auto gate, right? Auto gate.
Check it out.
Oh yeah, and one more thing before exporting. When you add effects in the effects rack, you just want to make sure you come down here and click apply, so you make sure your effects get exported. Awesome. And then tip number 3 would be the spot heal brush. In here, you can basically do spot healing, kind of like spot healing in Photoshop, how you can go in and sort of remove pimples and it sort of fills in with the surrounding pixels and stuff like that. You can sort of do the same thing by filling in the surrounding frequencies with different things with the spot heal brush, and it's pretty dope. Right here on the top of Adobe Audition are your tools. There's a normal paintbrush, lasso tools, selection tools, and things like that. Spot heal brush is right here, and you can see when you hover over it, it gives you a little shortcut thing here in the corner. It says B would be that, so you can just hit that. P is paintbrush and B is the other brush for spot healer. It sort of looks like a little band-aid kind of deal, which makes sense because it kind of put a little band-aid on your stuff here, right? You want to start by kind of going up top. It says show spectral frequency display. I think you can also just drag it up from this bottom window here too, actually, but you can also just easily click that there. And if you just pinch to zoom, you can go in and it kind of shows you a different view of what's going on here with the waves. And you can already kind of see there's a couple things clipping, like right here. Here, let me deselect this stuff really quick. Command D, you can deselect everything. So Command A, select everything, and Command D is deselect everything. But anyways, so if you go down here, you can sort of already see there's a couple spots where it's like clipping. For instance, let me, well, it might be kind of hard to see, but anyway, this isn't a big deal here, but you can basically go into where it's clipping and it will fill in with the surrounding frequencies. And
so 1 2, there's a fan,
so it's not clipping.
Me.
Let's see what
that's
else.
That's kind of crazy.
How about that? Check that out. Let's pretend like there's like a little bump there, and you can sort of see it's really hardcore kind of going on right here, right? Let's fill that in a little bit with a little spot healing, and how about all of this yellow where it looks pretty intense? See what happens. So, try one more thing. Do a couple tries here. Not really necessarily trying to get rid of that, but that's just showing you what this tool can do. Like I said, it sort of surrounds it with the surrounding pixels. And now there totally is a little bit of room tone right here, but I just took out that little clip. I have no clue how they get that to work. It's kind of insane that now you can go into certain frequencies and take them out, like you can remove pimples. That's insane.
Hey.
I believe all, like down here, these are all like the low frequencies, obviously, and it goes up to higher and higher. When you hear something, you can kind of use that as a general guide to sort of find it.
Microphone chip.
Anyway, that's the spot heal brush. Maybe this isn't a great example for the spot heal brush, but look. And of course, if you see other things peaking as well a little bit, you can simply, you can highlight where you're at and sort of just adjust the decibels a little bit.
1 2, there's a fit. Is it possible to take out that?
There's a little bit of like a little bit of a bassiness in that take out that buzz part. Let's see if we can find that little sucker.
Next to the fan, is it possible to take out that buzz?
And see how you can kind of see? It looks like it's probably right here.
Right next to the fan, is it possible to take out that buzz?
It's like, dude, just a little like breath or like a, just a deep bassy sound right there. Let's see what happens there.
Possible to take out that buzz?
That was pretty close, y'all. That was pretty close.
Take out that butt.
But that's why I like this view of the waves as well, because it kind of gives you a different perspective and you can kind of really makes things sort of jump out a little bit at you, so you can just have a different perspective and see what you're trying to get out.
And is it possible to take out that buzz?
Now that bassiness isn't even in there anymore. Check it out.
And is it possible to take out that buzz?
I'm all right. And we're going to go up to file, export file. Call it whatever you want. Let's call it, how about I like a do the cha-cha. How does that sound? We'll just send it to the desktop right now. Send it to wherever you want. We can do a wave. Let's do that. This is the original. This is the original right here.
Hey, microphone check 1, 2.
Already off the bat, I can hear way more fan and people talking in the background.
1, 2, there's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this little fan near me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise?
So basically there's the fan, there's people talking, you can hear a lot of the room tone and stuff, and it's just not very clean and isolated, which is what you want, because you want to be able to add those effects and things later. And it literally just sounds like where we recorded it in the room.
Oh, you hear that little buzz?
Alright, and then, you know, and there's a couple pops and things like that we took out too. Alright, now let's hear the fixed one.
Hey, microphone check 1, 2. 1, 2, there's a fan near me. 1, 2, there's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this little fan near me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise underneath?
So it's definitely not perfect, but it's a lot better. Again, mess around with the settings until you get something great. I'm just kind of doing a quick little tutorial here to show you what's up with it.
There's a fan near me. That's kind of crazy. There's this little fan near me, and I'm wondering, could you quite possibly take out the fan noise underneath when I'm talking?
So you see there, especially if you're going to put some music underneath, it will just cover up any other extra imperfections and things, and then you got some nice clean awesome sounding audio.
Little.
But again, if you have the luxury to re-record, you should re-record, and you should always be monitoring your audio while on set and while recording. So if you need to capture something else or you miss something, and you have everybody there right then, and you can just get it done instead of all this extra work in post-production later on. Well, alright dogs, I hope you found it to be useful. There's a little bit of noise removal, a little bit of gate action, and some spot healing. I am Andrew with Friffy Films. Please consider subscribing if you're new here, and we hope to see you again on our next episode of Quick Tips. Peace.